will send a curse upon you, and of your blessing I will make a curse.
You recall, brothers and sisters, our toil and drudgery.
Some very scathing criticisms of the religious leadership during the time of Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
In order to prepare our hearts to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we take a moment to ask for the Lord's help, that we might live wholeheartedly the call to being his disciples. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us all to life everlasting.
Amen.
We pray for a moment in the quiet of our hearts. Sovereign God, we have no father but you, no teacher but Christ. Conform our lives to the faith we profess. Preserve us from arrogance and pride, and teach us in Christ the greatness of humility and service. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A proclamation from the book of the prophet Malachi. A great king am I, says the Lord of hosts, and my name will be feared among the nations. And now, O priests, this commandment is for you. If you do not listen, if you do not lay it to heart, to give glory to my name, says the Lord of hosts, I will send a curse upon you, and of your blessing I will make a curse. You have turned aside from the way and have caused many to falter by your instruction. You have made void the covenant of a Levi, says the Lord of hosts. I, therefore, have made you contemptible and base before all the people, since you do not keep my ways, but show partiality in your decisions. Have we not all one Father? Has not the one God created us? Why then do we break faith with one another, violating the covenant of our ancestors? The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A proclamation from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, we were gentle among you, as a nursing mother cares for her children. With such affection for you, we were determined to share with you not only the gospel of God, but our very selves as well, so dearly beloved had you become to us. You recall, brothers and sisters, our toil and drudgery, working night and day in order not to burden any of you. We proclaimed to you the gospel of God. And for this reason, we too give thanks to God unceasingly that in receiving the word of God from hearing us, you received not a human word, but as it truly is, the word of God, which is now at work in you who believe. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And also with you.
A proclamation of good news according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
And may the Lord be in our minds, on our lips, and in our hearts. Jesus spoke to the crowds and to his disciples, saying, "The scribes and the Pharisees have taken their seat on the chair of Moses. Therefore, do and observe all things whatsoever they tell you. But do not follow their example, for they preach, but they do not practice. They tie up heavy burdens, hard to carry, and lay them on people's shoulders, but they will not lift a finger to move them. All their works are performed to be seen. They widen their phylacteries and lengthen their tassels. They love places of honor at banquets, seats of honor in synagogues, greetings in the marketplaces, and the salutation, Rabbi. As for you, do not be called Rabbi. You have but one teacher, and you are all brothers and sisters. Call no one on earth your father. You have but one Father in heaven. Do not be called master. You have but one master, the Christ. The greatest among you must be your servant. Whoever exalts himself will be humbled, but whoever humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord. These October weekends, we've been presented with many challenging scriptures, parables of what the kingdom of God is like, how God's reign is breaking in among us, some very scathing criticisms of the religious leadership during the time of Jesus, all of which calls us to be disciples in word and in deed. Today's particular gospel reminds me of what is said to a deacon when a deacon is ordained to serve the church. The scriptures are presented to the deacon by the bishop, and the bishop says, "Believe what you read. Preach what you believe. Practice what you preach." It's been a wonderful focus during all of October as we celebrate Respect Life, all the various dimensions of life in this world that are to be cherished and respected and appreciated and reverenced, from the preborn to natural death and everything in between. And so it's been a particularly enlightening month with these scriptures kind of shot through with all the various dimensions of the Respect Life issues. And this weekend, we're very blessed to conclude the month of October, focusing on one of the ways in which we participate as a faith community in some of the life issues of caring for the homeless and the hungry. One of our outreach ministries is the St. Ben's Meal Program and all of the various ministries surrounding that. And so we're very blessed this weekend to have with us Brother Dave Schwab, Capuchin Franciscan, who works at the St. Ben's Meal Program and is going to share with us some of the dimensions of their ministry that we participate in with our parish outreach. And we welcome you, Brother Dave.
Thank you, Father Mike, and I appreciate the opportunity of being here at St. James. The line in the gospel that jumped out at me this morning was that the greatest of us must be the servant of all. And I know for a fact that St. James parishioners have been involved at St. Ben's since 1981. Happy 30th anniversary. That is astounding to me in terms of servanthood and commitment, to think that for 30 years you've been bringing food down and sharing it with our homeless folks. I think that's a real good model of servanting. I'd like to expand. Obviously, many of you are familiar with our meal site. That's something we've been doing. Actually, this will be our 41st year in November. And we feed an average of 325 people per night. So it's a big challenge. And as director, I am just amazed. You know, each day at 4:30, the cars roll up with the food. People bring it in, deliver it to the folks in the evening. I mean, it's just a marvelous display of service and commitment. However, we also have a whole range of other services. When you're dealing with homeless people, there are a lot of needs. Certainly, emergency clothing is one of those items, hygiene products. I took a car full of hygiene items and blankets last night, so you're already contributing a lot, and I see there's more out there this morning. Those are critical needs for homeless people. We also provide ID assistance. For a homeless person, the Wisconsin State ID is their passport to services, so we really are committed to providing that. Prescription co-pays, that's probably our biggest ticket item. The fact that, you know, you can get health care, and we all know how expensive that is today, but to meet that co-pay is very critical. Our newest venture is the Capuchin Apartments. We just opened those in August through the partnership with Heartland Housing of Chicago and the city of Milwaukee, as well as the county, all participating and helping with that project. It's 38 apartments, and I'm happy to say that they're already filled. 38 people who were either chronically homeless or mentally ill have moved in and are settling in. Dion is one of the residents, and he addressed us at the dedication, and he said, "My home was a bus stop on 8th and Wisconsin this summer." And here he is moving into this very nice apartment and learning the life skills that are necessary to keep that apartment going. And that all is due to the generosity of donors and benefactors, so I'm very grateful for that. I won't belabor a lot of this. I do have some materials in the back if you'd like to pick up some of those afterwards. If you're into the internet, our website is stbensmilwaukee.com. So check us out there. But thank you for your time and attention and your generosity.
And we're very grateful, Brother Dave, that you are joining us this weekend, sharing with us the ministry and the ways in which we participate in that. And I would encourage all of you to stop after Mass in the gathering space and say good morning to Brother Dave and learn a little bit more about St. Ben's and the many ministries that take place there. Please stand for our renewal of faith. We believe in one God, Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the dead, and the life. From deep within our hearts, we offer these prayers, asking God to be present to all in need.
Our response will be, "Hear us, O Lord." For the church, for Christians throughout the world who gather to pray on this day, O God, we pray,
"Hear us, O Lord."
For leaders, for those with influence in government, in business, in the media, in the church. O God, we pray.
Hear us, O Lord.
For parents, teachers, coaches, and all who serve as worthy models for young people. O God, we pray.
Hear us, O Lord.
For children, for their safety as they celebrate Halloween, and for the well-being of all children, especially those with no one to care for them. O God, we pray.
Hear us, O Lord.
For the sick, for all those who are living with cancer, heart disease, diabetes, mental illness, chronic pain, and other conditions that make day-to-day life difficult. O God, we pray.
Hear us, O Lord.
For the people in Turkey who are suffering due to a devastating earthquake, may they see the face of Jesus in the helping hands of others. O God, we pray.
Hear us, O Lord.
For all those signed in our Book of Life, for all those we love and miss, and especially Maria Felski, for whom this Eucharist is offered. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord. Gentle God, you protect the powerless. With humble and contrite hearts we pray. Be merciful to us, hear and grant our petitions this day. For we pray in the name of your Son, Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Our presentation song will be "To Be a Servant," found on page 17.
Pray, friends, that these are gifts, the many gifts of our lives, may all be acceptable to God, our Heavenly Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
Amen. God of mercy, may we offer a pure sacrifice for the healing of all the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right to give you thanks. It is fitting that we offer you praise, Father of mercy, faithful God. You sent Jesus Christ, your Son, among us as Redeemer and Lord. He was moved with compassion for the poor and the powerless, for the sick and the sinner. He made himself neighbor to the oppressed. By his words and actions, he proclaimed to the world that you care for us as a father cares for his children. And so with the angels and the saints, we sing the joyful hymn of your praise.
Pages 9 and 10.
You are truly blessed, O God of holiness. You accompany us with love as we journey through life. Blessed too is your Son, Jesus Christ, who is present among us and whose love gathers us together. As once he did for his disciples, Christ now opens the scriptures for us and breaks the bread. Great and merciful Father, we ask you to send down your Holy Spirit to hallow these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the eve of his passion and death, while at table with those he loved, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
Thank you.
And so, Father, most holy, we celebrate the memory of Christ, your Son, whom you led through suffering and death on the cross, to the glory of the resurrection and a place at your right hand. Until Jesus, our Savior, comes again, we proclaim the work of your love. We offer you the bread of life, the cup of eternal blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ entrusted to us. Through the power of your Spirit of love, include us now and forever among the members of your Son, whose body and blood we share. Lord, perfect your church in faith and love, together with Benedict, our Pope, Jerome, and Donald, our bishops, and all who serve your people. Open our eyes to the needs of all. Inspire us with words and deeds to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Keep our service of others faithful to the example and the command of Christ. Let your church be a living witness to truth and freedom, to justice and peace, that all people may be lifted up by the hope of a world made new. Be mindful of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith only you can know. Lead them to the fullness of the resurrection. Gladden them with the light of your face. When our pilgrimage on earth is complete, welcome us into your heavenly home, where we shall dwell with you forever. There with Mary and Joseph, the apostles and prophets, Saint James and all your saints, we shall praise you and give you glory through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and
with the words Jesus taught us, we pray for the daily bread we need. Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
And also with your spirit.
And we share a sign of the Lord's peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, our way, our truth, and our life. Blessed are we who are drawn to this table. Lord,
I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be with
you. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus bring us to life everlasting. I invite forward the ministers of communion for the homebound. Our sisters and brothers who can't be here are also a part of our great prayer of thanksgiving, and so we're grateful for your ability to bring them the Eucharist so they too can be fed with the bread from heaven. We send you with our prayers for them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord, you give us new hope in this Eucharist. May the power of your love continue its saving work among us and bring all to the joy you promise. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
And here are a few announcements. If you have brought back your census form that you got in the mail, please drop it off in the marked box in the gathering area. The Knights of Columbus will be selling their 2012 entertainment books as well in the gathering area. During the month of November, we remember those who have gone before us. Our Jacob's Ladder will again be available to bring pictures of dear ones, and you can find more information in the bulletin. The month of October is Respect for Life Month. Respect life is one of the core principles of Catholic social teaching. To help support local Respect for Life organizations, there will be volunteers handing out Lifesavers candy, symbolizing saving a life after Mass. Please look for the volunteers at each door and help support Respect for Life through your donation. And Tuesday is the Feast of All Saints. Mass will be here at church at 8 o'clock a.m. and at 6 o'clock p.m.
And be sure to stop and say hello to Brother Dave in the gathering space after Mass. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And as we go forth, please sing together on page 19, the Song of Good News, 19.